Hi and welcome to Coding with Dennis. I'm Dennis. In this video, I'll show you how to set up the shape modeling library Skelismo to use the IntelliJ IDE from JetBrains. So let's get right into it. Let us start out on the Skelismo website. Then we go to the docs menu where there is a link to the Skelismo using an IDE setup instruction. So Skelismo is written in Scala, which runs on the Java runtime engine, and therefore we need a version of Java installed. Currently, either version 8 or 11 works well with together with the Skelismo and Scala. Especially on OS X, we've often seen people having problems finding the correct Java version to use. So to help with this problem, we make use of Cursier, which is a dependency solver written in Scala. In this video, we're using a Mac running OS X Big Sur. But the same steps can also be performed on other OS X versions or on Linux. If you are on Windows, you simply perform the three commands as written here in the guide. So let's open a terminal and install Cursier. Then we open up a new terminal window to be able to use Cursier. And make use of the Cursier CS command to install the Java version we want. In this case, we choose the Sulu JVM 11, which we found works very well together with Skelismo. We can check the current system version of Java by invoking CS Java -version. In case the wrong version is mentioned, try to open up a new terminal and try again. And finally, you might want to know the location of where Cursier installed the JVM, which is also given in the tutorial. Now we can create a new Skelismo Hello World project by using SPT. We'll first create a repository folder called MyTestRepo. We change the directory into that directory, and then we use the Skelismo seed as the template for our new project. We call our project Test1. If nothing is chosen, then the default project name is Skelismo seed. Once everything has been downloaded, we can change the project directory and use SPT run to run the project. If everything worked out, the Skelismo UI with a face mask should show up. The next step is to download and install the IntelliJ IDE from JetBrains. When installing IntelliJ, remember to install the Scala plugin during the installation. Alternatively, this can be done from the plugin configuration menu. Search for Scala and make sure that it is installed. We can now go ahead and import the test1 project into IntelliJ. The SPT panel on the side can be used to download all the packages specified in the build.spt file. If you make an update to the build file, remember to reload all SPT projects. Now go ahead and find the example app file under source, right click and select run to compile and run the project. Sometimes you might have problems with IntelliJ not automatically finding an appropriate Java version, so let's try to make a new project called test2 and import that. An alternative way to import a project is from the File menu. Select File, New and Project from Existing Source. Then select the Test2 project folder. Import Project from External Module and select SPT. In the Project JDK, select Download JDK and choose Azul Solo Community as the vendor. And click download. Now go ahead and sync SPT for the project and try to run the project file again. Sometimes I have the problem that the right Java version is not picked up on a freshly installed machine. It will then show you an error that the main class could not be found. I'm mainly able to solve this by simply importing the project again. In the project JDK, you need to choose the actual JDK that was just downloaded. When finally trying to run the project again, the UI should pop up as expected. And now, you're finally ready to explore the functionality of Scalismo within the IntelliJ IDE. As a simple test, we can change the color of the face to blue and see that the color indeed is changing when running the application again. And with that, we are at the end of the video. For general questions and troubleshooting using Scalismo, have a look at the Google mailing list, which I'll be linking in the description of the video. If you have problems following the steps in the video or ideas for future videos, please leave me a comment below. And so, see you back in the next video.